Father, Deputy, Sir General, John the Lady, distinguished guests, officers and members of the Mayo Society, I would like to say I am thrilled to be here, and I thank the Mayo Society for considering me worthy of this recognition. Having left Mayo at a very young age, arriving in New York City was a real born-again experience. The fact that I came to welcoming relatives and following my childhood friend and classmate, Anne Gillespie, who emigrated 6 months earlier, eased fears a little. What an amazing time it was. There was Irish dance halls and bands all over the city where you met people from every county in Ireland. Fast forward a few years, I had met and married Eddie Fee from Castleblaney, County Monaghan, which solidified the Irishness. Our kids were enrolled in dance classes with Sarah McNiff, Music of Morning Glen, and so ensued the trips to Ireland, to the Mansion House for the All World, to Ennis, the Stowe, etc. for the Clock Hill. I was getting to see the country with our kids. My husband, on more than one occasion, reminded me that he showed me around Mayo. And he loved it there, especially when he hooked up with Paddy Murphy, husband of a cousin of mine, who hailed from Glenmoy, I think. Since he always sang the fair of Glenmoy. Anyway, around that time, the number of children involved in dancing competitions was burgeoning. A baby boom, so to speak. The parents, in an effort to provide better conditions and prizes for our competitors, formed the Parents and Students Irish Dancing and Music Association, of which I became a member. Later, at the nudging of my brother-in-law, the late Tom Crown, who was then president, I became an officer, and I guess I moved up through the ranks. Now, here was a group of people who were truly dedicated to the promotion of our culture. We ran annual fashana in beautiful settings all over the Tri-State area, usually on a Sunday, so there were wonderful family outings. Around 72, the organization became affiliated with the St. Patrick's Day Parade under the leadership of Larry Dooley. And have been proudly marching up Fifth Avenue ever since. Bernadette Lee coordinates the dance. She's been doing this for about 18 years and hasn't paid yet.
Thank you.
We now have the next generation participating. Eileen Daly, who chairs this event, runs a tight ship. If you show up in jeans, you have to run to a store and buy a pair of pants. And the competitors, the dancers in the parade are from various schools in the Tri-State area, so it makes a spectacular color event on the avenue. And on that note, goes to John Vanity and his committee, who has preserved. I'm okay, I'll be okay. Who has preserved this great privilege for all of us. You have to attend parade meetings to get some idea of what is behind the scenes in getting the display of such magnitude on Fifth Avenue. I had the great privilege of viewing it from the grandstand last year when Joe King of Anton's here and I were selected as large from Mary Higgins Clark and marched behind her horse and carriage on the most beautiful day imaginable. It was the experience of a lifetime. Again, I am proud to say that my four granddaughters are continuing the tradition, hello, marching in the parade each year. My oldest granddaughter is Fiona Conway.
There she is. Yay.
That would be a daughter of Bernadette Fee and Brian Conway of Fiddle Music. three carols are Marie, Trina, and Angela. Daughters of Michael Fee and Noreen McComiskey.
So the there they are, say hello.
None. They have visited Ireland and attended Buck Show, where their father drummed for a Kelly band. This honor has been more than I ever dreamed of in my wildest imaginings. On my last trip, I got to see the Crawford Pond at Charlotte Park Museum in Castlebar, and the 4,000 years Scots pine, no, 4,000 years plank that it involved at the Neolithic excavation at Cato Field. The Mayo Society should stand proud among the counties. From that first fall at Tammany Hall, where the proceeds went back to Mayo, there has always been stalwarts of the house. In conclusion, I would like to thank all of them who helped the cause this evening. Students, Irish dancing, fellow. My sister and brother-in-law, Joe and Jim Collins, and our cousin Mary and Dennis McNally. Dory Aaron, and my fellow set dancers, and I would like to really thank those people that came from Boston. Eamon has established the name to be as a builder in the Boston area. And he's also a pilot and would have flown in if Joe King had the script ready. Also, cousins, Terry and Billy Hall, travels from Boston.
Wow.
So, I hope you will enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you all. Thank you all for supporting.
Beautiful piece of Mayo Christmas. And the inscription reads, this honour is bestowed upon Mary Fee, Mayo Woman of the Year, in grateful recognition of her tireless commitment, extraordinary service in the preservation of Irish traditions. The Mayo Society Incorporated, the City of New York, 1879, Entrance Queens Village, New York, March 10, 2012. Reason Lighting Lens President Michael S. Regan and Kathy Lighten Schmidt Chairpersons.